Here are the top 5 print on demand mistakes in my opinion. And remember, I said my opinion. Everyone's gonna have their own, you know, top mistakes. So before we get started, please remember to hit that like button. It really helps with the YouTube algorithm. Hit the subscribe button. And obviously, don't forget to hit the bell notification. And let's get started with the top 5 mistakes. Number 1 is don't fall in love with your designs. Meaning if you spend hours making a design, it doesn't mean it's amazing. And most people fall in love with their design. They think it's amazing, they think it's the best, they think it's gonna sell, and they won't take no for an answer. And this is very common for many areas in life. For example, when you're writing, you know, an essay or anything, when you read that back, you don't necessarily see the mistakes someone else will see. Just the grammatical errors or the punctuation errors or whatever it may be, you don't necessarily see them because you wrote it, you did the work. So the point I'm trying to make, okay, is don't be scared. Don't think, you know, your design is amazing and it's gonna sell. Just don't be scared to give up on a design and move on. If it's not getting sales, maybe it wasn't that good. Number 2 is instant success does not exist. Okay, some people are under the assumption that you upload to, you know, Redbubble or Amazon and then you start getting sales. That's not actually true. It could take weeks, it could take months, it could take absolutely ages to start getting any print on demand sales. The same goes for YouTube. When I upload a YouTube video, yes, at this point I expect it to get, you know, a couple hundred views, maybe a couple thousand views. But by no means do I expect it to get 10, 20, 30,000 views. In fact, all the videos, you know, that I've posted that have over 50,000 views have taken months and months and months to get those views. The same goes for t-shirts. We upload so many so that we increase our chances of actually getting sales, and hopefully down the line, you know, we will start getting sales. Number 3 is not using tags properly. This is the most important fundamental part of any business out there. If you want to get seen, you need to start using tags. You need to start using the relevant keywords so that you show up on Google, you show up on, let's say you're selling on Redbubble or Amazon, wherever it is, you need to start making yourself available to everyone, basically. And you do that through the right keywords, through the right tags. Now, you could, you know, upload 100,000 designs and be like, I don't need to use tags. And you're probably right. If you've got 100,000 designs, you might not need to worry so much about tags. But I feel like that's a bit out of our landscape and we don't have 100,000 designs. So just focus on the designs you do have and make sure that they are keyword rich, meaning they have lots and lots of keywords in, so hopefully they can rank in Google. And you've put all the necessary tags in them. In terms of what tags to be using, I recommend 2 methods here. The first one is to use the Google Keyword Planner tool, and this will give you a great range of keywords that you can use, and it'll also tell you how many searches they're getting per month, so you can see how popular they are. And the second is just to have a look at your competition, see what tags they're using. There's nothing wrong with using the same tags as your competition. That's not considered stealing or anything. You're not taking their design, you're just using the same tags as them, okay? But just note, the most important thing, and I said this before, but I need to stress it, the most important thing is make sure those tags are relevant to you. Number 4 is not placing the shirt in the right place. Now, I don't need to go into this at all because I've said it so many times in so many videos, but just quickly, in one sentence, make sure your design is on the chest, not on the belly. That is it. Let's move on to the 5th and final thing. And finally, don't price yourself out the market, be it a t-shirt, a tote bag, a sticker. Make sure you do all the relevant research to, you know, find out exactly how much you should be charging. See what others are actually charging and, you know, don't focus on the guy on page 30 getting 0 sales who's charging £25 for a t-shirt. Focus on the guy on page 1 who's getting all the sales. What's he selling at? When I did research on the dog niche, I found that a lot of people were selling it at £14. And then I saw a lot of your designs at £22. Now, I know the quality of the t-shirt's slightly different, but my point is you are pricing yourself slightly out the market. You want to be competitive, so you need to start pricing yourself similar to what the top sellers are pricing themselves at. Because at the end of the day, these print-on-demand products aren't, you know, luxury products, they aren't luxury quality, so there's no reason for them to have luxury prices associated with them. They're meant to have cheaper prices with them because they're kind of like cheaper, gimmicky products. Those are the top 5 mistakes I could think of. Let me know down in the comments below if you can think of any other five mistakes that I haven't yet mentioned. I really, really enjoy reading all your comments and I genuinely enjoy replying to all of them. So if you have any thoughts about anything, let me know in the comments down below and I will reply. And yeah, thank you so much for watching.